honest to government, I found out a way and I didn't record it because I wasn't paying much attention. But here we are. I know it was Ellis. I just killed one guy over there. I was just checking them out over there. All three of them out. Oh, this is beast. This is beast. I think things are growing. It's awesome. You can end up just like him if you want. Nothing really happened, and trust me, nothing happened, dude. Don't be under there. If you're gonna be under there, just don't. Cause you know what's gonna happen to all of you guys. You know it. You better come over here. I could take you down too for get that guy and he comes off us. They put mines in your face. Got this guy too. Underneath. I don't know why they're so stupid, they don't even know this. No one wants to hurt you. Big bad boy. How to take care of it. This guy is a person here. We got this. Help him out. There you go, that's 8.
I'm in shock, okay? Can't believe what I'm seeing.
Okay. Now, walking down here.
I'll need to evacuate this lab of cryovapor before the lockdown protocol on this door is disengaged.
person who did this. And it was safe.
The super coolant from Victor's lab to activate the cryo drill.
Oh, okay. Now I gotta do what I'm here to do. Yeah, I can do what I want to do.
There's more going on here than a simple accident. This security guard's skin has the same blue coloration as Freeze's. I should set up a crime scene. Data analysis indicates that he died from a heat stroke, but the control room doesn't show signs of overheating.
Okay, now I'm gonna use the flood, I guess. Oh, he crawled too. Cause that was probably like that, yeah.
This is some kind of crystallized chemical residue. Traces lead back into the lab. Here. I should scan for more evidence. Two men struggled. One of them ran out of the lab. That would be the dead security guard I found. These palm prints are a match for Victor Freeze. He must have watched the security guard die. Freeze scavenged what he needed from various prototypes to build himself a super cooled survival suit. Extreme pressure built up inside the tank when ice sealed these outtakes. It appears that this guard was frozen by the cryo vapors from the resulting explosion. The evidence suggests the guard was frozen when the tank ruptured, programs by Freeze's cryocannon. These DNA traces are a match for Victor Freeze. Spatter analysis suggests a blunt impact. Someone assaulted Freeze with a weapon. The cannon was knocked over and fired. When the tank exploded, it released a plume of cryochemicals. The plume enveloped Freeze and the guard, but the shockwave knocked the assailant clear. I need to find that weapon. It may have evidence I can use to identify the assailant. DNA analysis confirms the gun was used to bludgeon Victor Freeze, and fingerprint analysis shows Ferris Boyle. It was Ferris. Something was wheeled through this fluid, possibly a gurney. The fluid must have frozen almost immediately for these tracks to have been preserved.
I'm freeze that car, because I don't want to walk out of there.
Odd. Freeze was secretly doing research on Huntington's Korea, but this is a cryogenic weapons lab. The test subject was Nora Freeze. Now I know what happened here. Boyle hired Victor to help advance the secret cryo-weapons program within Gothcorp. In exchange, Boyle agreed to devote Gothcorp resources to finding a cure for Nora's Huntington's. But Boyle was more interested in how Victor had managed to put Nora into cryostasis. When Victor realized that Boyle had no intention of following through on their deal, he decided to do the Huntington's research himself. But Boyle didn't like that. The cryochemical cocktail altered Victor's metabolism, as well as the guards. Boyle escaped ahead of the plume and had the lab quarantined. Victor survived, but he knew that leaving the supercooled lab would kill him. So he built himself a suit and utilized an organic supercoolant to keep his core temperature sub-zero. All this violence. He's just trying to save his dying wife. The supercoolant Victor uses in his suit is the same fluid I need for the cryo drill.
I wish I could save that dude, but I can't. No, pardon me. Too bad, dude, I can't save you. It's not letting me. I wish I could.
Alfred, send Gordon the evidence I've gathered on Boyle's crimes.
I'm sorry, Master Bruce. I know you had high hopes for what Ferris could do for Gotham.
That doesn't matter now. Victor's plan was never to kill Boyle. He needs Boyle's security access to get his wife out of Gothcorp. That's all he wants.
And now, you're going to stop him?
I have to.
And are you still going to need that gurney?
I am. But not for Victor.
You know what I'm gonna do? We're not gonna have it here. I'm gonna have Captain pull me a nice hot and then I'm gonna drown you with it.
I'm trying, boss. Besides, it's tough.
Oh, you can't believe
that! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Who is this boss?
Get out of here, bloody
yes!
Now, while he's holding
Sir, you can overload those cryo generators using your thermal gloves. Look for the control panel.
I'll pause it right here, see what happens with my friend Center, which I have to do because my friend Scorch won't do it. So I'm gonna check back with him, see what he's up to, gonna do the video and stuff. And the last part, this is part 5, thank you for watching. We're gonna complete part 6, and I think it's gonna be the last one. Thanks for watching, and have a good day. Bye.